For years I was ensnared in your deceptive spider webs. I wanted you to be my eternal highness. But most of all, Claude. What I wanted was your love. That's all a pipe dream now. One I left behind when I moved on from the mortal world. So often do people say that before the moment of your death, your life flashes before your eyes. I never truly believed it, of course. I thought it only a silly saying meant to encourage children into living good lives, ones they wouldn't regret viewing at the last moments of their life. But after that night, I know it's not just some silly story. It's true. It's a shame, really. I had to die in order to see what was right in front of me. You never cared about me, Claude. All you ever wanted was my soul. And the moment you were able to get your greedy hands on one that was better, in your opinion, you abandoned me. You sacrificed me for your own personal gain. How could I have expected anything different from a demon? In all my years, there was never anyone who stayed by my side. Everyone left me. Except for them. The human one. When my life was flashing before my eyes, I recall seeing them in every memory. They were here long before I was. They were my age. I remember that much. Though I can't quite recall their name. Funny how you start to forget things when you die. None of it matters anymore. So why should you hold on to it? I do remember their face, though. They were here when I arrived. They were kind to me. Of course. Under the circumstances, I couldn't bring myself to do anything but loathe them. Now, I find myself wondering why they stayed. I dismissed the old loon's servants. Asked you, Claude, to set the remaining boys free. But they stayed behind. That's one of the interesting things about humans, isn't it? We can take any place and turn it into a home. And once we do so, it becomes increasingly more difficult to leave. Until we die, that is. We fight so hard to stay in one place. The world which we know and love. Yet when it's our time to go, there's nothing we can do about it. We can't even fight back. So ridiculous it seems now, even bothering to fight. We're all ending up in the same place, one way or the next. We all end up 6 feet under. Why won't you look at me? Why can't you hear me? Surely you must hear me. You are always able to hear me. Perhaps you're simply ignoring me. You are quite fond of doing that. Fine then. In life and in death, your attention is never mine. But I suppose it's for the best. If your eyes could meet mine, what would I even say? For many years you were a faithful servant. I have no complaints. You did as you said you would. You made certain Sebastian would never get to taste Ciel's soul. But what you did to me, it was unnecessary. It was cruel. You did it for your own benefit, not mine, as you should have. Huh? You? Yes, you. Can you hear me? Tell me. Do you remember who I am? I feel as though I had two names once. I could remember them a moment ago. I know I could. But my memory is fading. Right. I was your master, Alois Trancy. Before that? A homeless, orphan boy. Jim Larkin. I remember that too. Yes. Yes, I remember you. You and Claude hold a special place in my memories. Now more than ever, you alone hold a special place in my heart. Though I'm afraid, with death, my memory has begun to fade away. I can't recall your name. I can't recall how many times I yelled at you, scolded you, perhaps even raised a hand to you. But I know how many years you were there for me. I had to die in order to see it all again. But it's there, clear as day. You were the one. You were the only one who truly cared about me. It is true, and you know it. I've come to learn that Hannah only cared for me because she cared for Luca, and he cared for me as well. She cared for him, so she cared for me, to make him happy. But you cared because, well, you just did. There was no rhyme or reason to it. It was just how you felt about me. But the thing I love most about you caring for me is the fact that you accepted it. You embraced it. You didn't think it was wrong. That's why you stayed, isn't it? That's why you remain here now. The others are here to see this plan through until the end. But you? You have no reason to be here. You're only here because you cared for me when I was alive. And you can't bear to leave me just yet. Why are you crying? Don't utter another word of that nonsense. You made it clear enough when you agreed to stay. I was just too blinded. Blinded by my desire for revenge to see that you loved me, didn't you? While I was here, you grew fond of me. In the back of my mind, I grew fond of you as well. It's strange. I'm bound to this earth, wandering aimlessly until time itself ceases to exist. You're the only one who pays attention to me now, and I can finally see it. No, I won't leave you. I promise, I won't leave you. Of course I'll stay with you forever. Why? Because you love me. All I've ever wanted was to be loved. You love me. I want to stay with you. And since you want me to stay as well, what harm could it do to stay? But what? Impossible. I could never be at peace knowing you're all alone. Knowing that if I'm at peace, I'll be alone as well. And I've heard, when your soul disappears, all you see is darkness. I don't want to be alone in that darkness. So if I can stay here, with you in the light, where I am loved, where I am cared for, where I can always watch over you, I want to stay right here for all eternity. And when your time has come, we can walk into that darkness together, hand in hand, with smiles on our faces. Wouldn't that be just lovely?